Welcome all in today's webinar on first step towards WebAssembly with Rust. This is Pankaj Chaudhary. I am working as software consultant at Noldus. So Noldus is a team of passionate technologists specializing in the field of functional programming, reactive programming and big data. So without further ado, let's start today's webinar. So this will be our agenda for today. First, we will quickly discuss about Rust, the programming language which we will use in the WebAssembly. Then we will discuss about WebAssembly. After that, we will discuss about WebAssembly architecture, followed by some hands-on examples. At last, we will discuss about how and where you should use WebAssembly. So starting from Rust. Rust is a multi-paradigm system programming language that can provide better memory safety while maintaining high performance. It runs blazingly fast, prevents almost all the crashes and eliminates data races. It has an exceptional feature of memory management which can be achieved by ownership concept. These are some key features of Rust, in which first is fixed common memory safety problems. Actually, it has some cool features like ownership and borrowing which can guarantee the memory safety. It can also have some features like simple mutable, multiple immutable and no null only options. Actually, the Rust has only no nulls. It has only options. Either we have some or none. So next is performance. So Rust can build the binary which can directly run on the bare metal, so its performance is very high. And next is portability and scalability. So every 6 weeks the Rust new stable version is released, which can fix about all the problems, so it is more stable than other languages. So to understand the importance of memory safety features of Rust, we can take a look on Microsoft Vulnerability Survey report. This is a survey on the vulnerabilities that occurred in Microsoft applications from 2006 to 2018, in which we can see that about 70% of vulnerabilities are because of memory safety issues. So the Rust will help us to decrease the major vulnerabilities from the application. So let's discuss about some large projects using Rust for its development. So first project is Amazon Firecracker. Amazon Firecracker is the virtualization technology that powers AWS Lambda, Fargate, and it's written completely in Rust. One of the technology's author offers insight into Firecracker and its related technologies in building the virtualization stack of futures and Rust Virtual Manager. Firecracker started life as the fork of Google's CrossVM, but quickly diverged due to offering need of two projects. Despite this, there are many common pieces that are best shared across the project and in any other virtual machine manager written in the Rust. With that in mind, the Rust Virtual Machine Manager project started as a way of Amazon, Google, Intel, and Red Hat to share its common crates to each other and rest of the open source community. These includes interfaces to KVM, which is Linux virtualization APIs, virtual device support, and a kernel loader. It's truly amazing to see some of the great tech giants of software industry working together around a common technology stack written in Rust. Next project is Windows Runtime. So Windows Runtime is a platform agnostic application architecture first introduced in Windows 8 and with Windows Server 2012 and 2016. As we all know, Microsoft has long depended on C++ as the backbone for so much of what they do, but it has some challenges, particularly when it comes to security. Modern C++ certainly make it easier to write safe and secure C++ if you follow certain careful conventions. But that is often hard to enforce a large project. Lust is a integrating language. It closely resembles C++ in many ways, hitting all the right notes when it comes to compilation, runtime model, type system, and deterministic finalization. While it has its own learning curve, it also has the potential to solve some of the most vexing issues that plague with C++ project, and is designed from the ground up with memory safety, safe concurrency as core principles. Next project is OneSignal. So OneSignal is a high volume and reliable push notification services for websites and mobile applications. So OneSignal uses Rust to deliver over 6 billion notifications per day. Next project is NPM. So NPM exponential growth drove the NPM engineering team to switch from Node.js to Rust to handle CPU bound tasks that were going to become a performance bottleneck. A recent white paper overviews the experience of developing the new services in Rust and running it in production for more than 1 year. Next project is Azure IoT. As you all know, Azure IoT is the product of Microsoft. So at this point, Azure IoT is completely on board with the Rust programming language. Uses of Rust has only expanded even more since they shipped Azure IoT Edge. Multiple cloud service projects that are currently being actively worked upon are being written in Rust. The trifecta of memory safety, data race safety, and performance that Rust offers has been a great fit for Azure IoT. Next project is Discord. So at Discord, they have seen success in Rust on the client side and server side. For example, they use it on the client side for our video encoding pipelines for Go Live, and on the server side for Elixir Nix. Most recently, they drastically improved the performance of service by switching its implementation from Go to Rust. Next project is Oxidation. So Oxidation is the project of Mozilla to integrate Rust code in and around Firefox. So the goal of this project is to make it easier and more productive to use Rust in Firefox, and correspondingly to increase the amount of Rust code in Firefox. Next project is Firefox Quantum. So Firefox Quantum is actually the Firefox 57 release, but the Mozilla developers have decided that the speed gains in the upcoming browser's milestone are so noteworthy that it should have a unique name as well. Mozilla has been incrementally adding features to Firefox over the past years to help and speed up the browser in an effort to provide better performance than Google's rival Chrome browser. So as a result, Mozilla developers demonstrate that Firefox Quantum is majorly faster than Google Chrome. So next project is Cloudflare. So Cloudflare is one of the biggest networks operating on the internet. People use Cloudflare services for purposes of increasing the security and performance of their websites and services. So Cloudflare serverless platform, Cloudflare Workers, now allows the compiler to compile the WebAssembly code and upload it to 150 plus data centers and invoke those functions just as easily as if they were in JavaScript functions. So there are also many other companies like Apple, Facebook and many others which are using Rust to improve their project's performances. So we will see it in future. So now let's get back to WebAssembly. So let's start WebAssembly. So before starting WebAssembly, let's look on how web development today is, or what are the problems in web development today. So I have separated the problems in three separate titles, like fragmented, slow and overwhelming. So I just want to discuss that in today's web development, as we are increasing the size of our applications, there are some problems which we are facing. Like the common problems is the application gets slower. Like most of you have seen some applications, I think Slack, most of you have used the Slack and facing that problems. So to overcome that problems, the WebAssembly comes into existence. So starting WebAssembly. So WebAssembly is also called as WASM. It is a portable binary code instruction format introducing in year 2015. It enables the compilation of high-level programming languages like C, Java, C++, or Rust. In WASM, a developer can write a code in any of the programming languages and then it is to be run on the web. This task is supported by WebAssembly. WebAssembly does the task of compiling the code into bytecode that can run in the web browser. This code is then converted into native machine code and thus finally executed. So many of you have some confusion like, is it a programming language? So no, it is not a programming language. It has a binary format which is not human readable. So you don't write in WebAssembly, you use WebAssembly to compile the web app codes written in the applicable programming languages. The role of WebAssembly is to aid the deployment of code in web or server apps, compiling and resulting in fast loading and execution of web apps. So these are some features of WebAssembly, in which first is efficient and fast. So because WebAssembly is very efficient and fast because the WASM stack machine is designed to encode it in a size and time load time efficient binary format. And next feature is safe, because the WebAssembly is using memory safe sandbox execution environment. Because when the WebAssembly runs, it runs in the modules and that modules is run in the sandbox execution environment. So next feature is open and debuggable. So WebAssembly is designed to be pretty printed in a textual format for debugging, testing, experimenting and writing programs by hand. Next is part of open web community. So WebAssembly is designed to maintain the visionless features tested, backward compatible nature of the web. So WebAssembly module will be able to call into out of the JavaScript contracts and access browser functionality. Through the same, web API is accessible from JavaScript. So WebAssembly also support non-web embeddings. So this is the architecture of WebAssembly, in which we can write the code in our programming language like Rust, C++ or C. Then we can compile that code into the WebAssembly code, which is .wasm file, and then this file will be executed with the help of JS JavaScript code. This is the like flow of WebAssembly or simple architecture, from where the code is converted to .wasm modules by the compiler, and with the help of JavaScript glue code it can run on the browser. So let's discuss about some common methods of WebAssembly, in which first is webassembly.compile. So this function compiles a WebAssembly module from WebAssembly binary code. This function is useful if it is necessary to compile a module before it is to be instantiated. And second method is webassembly.compileStreaming. So this function compiles a WebAssembly module directly from the streamed underlying source. This function is useful if it is necessary to be compiled a module before it is to be instantiated. Next method is webassembly.instantiate. So this function allows you to compile and instantiate WebAssembly code. Next method is webassembly.instantiateStreaming. So this function compiles and instantiates a WebAssembly module directly from a streamed underlying source. This is most efficient optimized way to load a WebAssembly code. And next method is webassembly.validate. So this function validates a given typed array of WebAssembly binary code written, whether the byte from a valid WebAssembly module is true or false. So let's hands on to WebAssembly. So if you are just a beginner and want to just start the WebAssembly, so you can also start from the WebAssembly Studio, which is the open source platform from where you can start developing WebAssembly apps. So here this will be open like that, from where you can starting like Hello World Rust project. You can create that project and start working on them. Like this is the Rust code, from where it has only one function, greet function. Here we have just said hello, and there is a JavaScript file from where this function is calling with world, and this world will be append with hello, and this is the HTML file with the help of by which it will execute. So we can build and run the application. So as you can see that WebAssembly Studio says hello world. So it was a notification program of WebAssembly with Rust. So let's close it and let's see more examples. So So let discuss the example. So in this example, I have made a Rust code of addition, and this is the JavaScript file for addition, from where we can call the add function with that argument 1 and 18 and log this result. And the second example is for DOM. So here we have write a code in Rust in which we have just make a callback function in which we have integrate a button into a that callback function. When we can click on that button, then the callback function will call and it will display that message which we have put in the arguments. And this is the JavaScript of that DOM file. So let's run that WebAssembly application and let's see the output. So as you can see, the application is running. So as we have made two examples, so first is addition in with Rust. So let's check the console. So the answer is 119. And if we want to change that function, like now it is working for addition, so if we want to multiply the things, like we can put multiply here, and in JavaScript file we can modify it like 5 and 18. So let's run this program again and let's see the output. So addition in Rust, we have to go on the console and we can see that the answer is 19. So the Rust code is working fine in our web browser. So let's check the next example which we have made. Like in this example, we can click on the button and the callback function will call and it will display some message which we have put in that code. So like that it will show us the message. So that's all from the demo perspective, and let's get back to the slide. So let's discuss about how WebAssembly will change the way to develop web applications. So first is compatible with all major operating systems and web browsers. So portability is the major trait of WebAssembly. It ensures efficient execution on the wide range of operating systems with just one compilation step. It will make the app run on any of the modern browsers. Next is offers programming language choice to developers. So WebAssembly allows developers to write the code in the language of his choice. After that, it compiled to that code into the bytecode which is run on the client web browser, then translated it into the native machine and then executed at high speed. WebAssembly serves a good compilation tool supporting many popular languages for the web. So the developers can enjoy the freedom of choice to the language for coding. Next is provide better load time to web applications. So WebAssembly is in binary format. File size is very smaller due to this format because its binary is lighter than textual JavaScript files. So WebAssembly is faster to decode. Actually, JavaScript converts the text into the AST, which is abstract syntax tree, first, and then it converts abstract syntax tree into the binary format. This increases the load time of the web apps, which can be reduced with the use of WebAssembly. So due to its easy to load capabilities, it will especially be useful in heavy applications. Next is ensure secure applications to users. So the modules of WebAssembly execute in the sandbox environment, which isolates the untested codes. So this offers users protection from the malicious modules. So let's discuss about where we should use WebAssembly. So if we can consider the pros of the WebAssembly, then it is the ideal use case are web heavy applications where load time is major requirement. So WebAssembly has a great scope in gaming, video editing, or music streaming applications. Businesses that were majorly using desktop apps earlier are now in need of web apps. So WebAssembly can be used to port your desktop applications to web. So I think a question will be in your mind that will the WebAssembly replaces the JavaScript? So the answer is no. WebAssembly has a high potential of JavaScript features and not a comparison to JavaScript. Actually, WebAssembly indeed has a potential to reduce the monopoly of JavaScript, but still not a replacement. Due to its limitless advantages, WebAssembly then used to with many popular web apps, programming languages like C++, Java, Rust, which would definitely offer a tough competition to JavaScript, if not replace it. So these are the references. So before leaving that webinar, I just want to inform you about the Rust Times, which is the bi-weekly newspaper of Rust by Noldus, on which you can see the Rust articles, jobs, event, and releases. So you can visit rusttimes.com for that. And to understand more or study more Rust, so you can go to the Noldus Rust page. From where you can read many things. So you can read our articles, which is written by the developer teams of Noldus, and you can see our webinars or meetup videos, and you can see our contributions or the Rust project which we have open source on the GitHub repositories. Okay, so thank you everyone. If you have any query, you can ask me on my mail pankaj.chaudhary@noldus.com, or you can send me a message on my LinkedIn. So थैंक यू सो मच फॉर ज्वाइनिंग।